Hello students, today I am going to enlighten you about Indian financial system. Financial system, as you all know, exists in a framework which enable us to transact financial transactions. Now, financial transactions, if I speak about, is an action which has been taken place between two individuals or two parties. It consists of three main parts: financial assets, financial institution, and financial market. We'll discuss individually all these things. Now, when I'm talking of financial assets, I'm referring to loans, that is, which is we borrow it from the bank or any of the financial institution, the deposits that we make in the bank, bonds which are being issued by various financial and non-financial organizations or even the companies. Equities are the shares which are being issued by the company, and other ways and means wherein we invest the money. Financial institutions are the ones through which we mediate our money. That is, banks, mutual funds, insurance company, merchant banks, etc. When I am discussing about financial market, I am referring to money market, which is basically consisting of short-term securities, that is, which is to be repaid to the market within a year, or the life of those securities is nothing less than a year. That's the maximum life. Capital market, when I am talking about, we are talking of the long-term securities which are issued in the market. Forex market, for example, is the foreign exchange market, and there are many more like commodities and other markets as well. Now, all these markets or the institution or even the assets which are issued in the market are being regulated in our country through various regulatory authority. That is RBI, Reserve Bank of India, SEBI, the Stock Exchange Board of India, IRDA is the Insurance Regulatory Authority. The functions of financial system. Now, this financial system helps in transferring the resources across time, that is, the duration within which it has to be transferred. Sectors, if I'm talking, it could be a commercial or a non-commercial sector, or it could be the retail sector, that is, we the individuals who are investing in the market, or even the corporate sectors. And the regions, we are talking of the various geographical boundaries. It can be within the country or abroad. The financial system manages risk for the economy. Now, when I'm talking of risk, this is something which is unforeseen circumstances. Nobody knows what is going to happen in future. Now, in order to curtail that, I will not say that we are going to finish it off. The risk can never be put to a zero. But yes, it can be minimized. So how can we minimize it? We can minimize it by taking an insurance for the same. Financial system pools and subdivides funds depending upon the need of the individuals, saver or the investor. Like if I am talking about myself, I require my funds to be put into some or the other investing means or methods of financial assets, then I need to keep in mind that when do I want this fund back as an investor. If I require to recover or get that money back within a year, that is, I am talking about short-term proposition. So I need to invest in money market, or I can invest in any of the banks. But if I am viewing for a longer perspective, then I am going for a large cap, or rather I should say capital market. This performs an important clearinghouse function which facilitates transaction between payers and payees. Now, what is a clearinghouse function? It's basically a function wherein the amount being invested or deposited by me will be debited in my account and it will be credited to the respective asset which I have purchased. For example, if I purchase shares of Reliance, then what is going to happen? My account will be debited, whereas Reliance company's account would be credited. And in my account, what would be coming in return? Shares. financial assets and instruments. Enable channelizing funds from surplus unit to deficit unit. Now, what financial assets can we buy? As I told you, we can buy any of the shares, mutual funds, or bonds, or debentures. Now, what is happening in this case? I have surplus amount of funds available with me, which I don't require. But in the economy, there are people who are requiring this fund. Now, in order to generate that fund, they either issue some bonds, some mutual funds, or some shares. Now, by buying those shares and bonds, what am I doing? My surplus units of funds is being transferred to the deficit area, that is, the ones who need it. And in return, I am getting the financial instrument. There are instruments for savers, such as deposits, equities, mutual fund units, etc. And in the same case, the thing which is a deposit for me becomes a loan for the other one. Because anything which is a gain for me in the form of an asset becomes a liability for the other party. So, there are instruments for borrowers such as loans, overdrafts, etc. Like individuals, like you and me, there are business, government, who can also raise funds by issuing bonds, treasury bills, etc. As an individual, I can also invest my money in PPF, that is Public Provident Fund, NSC, that is National Savings Certificates, which are also available to savers who wish to lend money to the government. Now, by buying or investing in all these funds and securities, what is going to happen? We are investing our excess surplus units and giving away to the government. So, this also enables the government to reduce the surplus flow of money in the economy and thereby curtailing inflation as well. So, this is one of the very major ways in which the government, this is one of the major tools in curtailing inflation in our economy. Now, what are the major financial instruments? First is the money, that is liquid cash, which is available with the people. We can invest or we can deposit the money in the savings account. That's the most easiest way in which one can have. And it's always suggested never to keep the money in our house, in our piggy banks. It's better to put it in the savings account. And a cautionary piece of advice, ensure that you deposit in banks which have good amount of creditworthiness and they are duly being recognized and nationalized banks which are available. Because then RBI comes for the rescue. Credit market instruments like bonds, mortgages, common stocks, over here we are talking of the equity market, money market funds and mutual funds, pension funds, wherein you are reassuring yourself about the fact that post-retirement, you are having a very comfortable life because you are getting due pensions or due earnings in order to lead your livelihood. Financial derivatives. Now, this is the financial flow in the economy. Financial market. In this market, the investors invest the money with the help of the bonds and the IPO. The saver either purchases government bonds. And in order to regulate all of them, the financial intermediaries are there who ensure that this regular flow is taking place. So, financial market caters both to the savers, financial intermediaries and the investors. By means of purchase of government bond, savers help to ensure their deposits by saving their salaries or meager income, whatever they have. The investors ensure that they generate money by borrowing it from the economy. Now that we are talking of financial institution. This includes institution and mechanism which affect generation of savings by the community. We need to ensure that is whatever retail investors save, that is a very large contributor in the economy by saving and regulating in the market. This is basically mobilization of saving which is taking place. Unless and until effective distribution of saving take place, this work being done will not be fruitful. So the banks and the other financial institution helps in channelization of saving. We generated saving by in lucrative offers, by giving them higher rate of interest, so people have saved the money. But the mobilization of saving and channelization of saving is the basic purpose which need to be sorted, so that the retail investors have good amount of faith in the institution. The institutions which we are discussing are the banks, insurance company, mutual funds. They are the ones who promote, mobilize or channelize the saving. Individual investors, when I am talking, we are not talking of corporates, we are talking of people like you and me, industries and trading companies or the borrowers. Now we are talking of the financial market. Money market are basically markets, as I told you before, they are for short-term funds which last less than a year. They are issued either by the banks or unorganized sector, that is the money lenders or the chit funds, which are unorganized and unauthorized by the government as well. Capital market are basically meant to issue or get long-term funds from the market. They are the primary issue market wherein the company is issuing shares to the general public. Now when I am talking of a stock market, now this is also known as a secondary market. What happens in there? That is, the investor purchases from the other investor, like selling of second hand goods. No role of the company takes place over here. If I have invested money in one company, say company A, company A will not be having any problem if I am selling it to investor B. Then is the bond market. Now what is organized money market? It's also known as call money market. Bill market consists of treasury bills and commercial bills. Bank loans. Now we are specifically talking of short term securities because we are talking of money market which lasts not more than a year. Organized money market comprises of RBI, banks, which can be commercial and cooperative. Now what is the basic purpose of a money market? Bank borrows in the money market too. How? They fill the gap or temporary mismatch of funds. Like for example, if the bank is required to maintain a particular CRR, that is the cash reserve ratio, or statutory liquidity ratio, that is they have money but right now for 15 days or 20 days or for a particular period of short term period, say for a month or two, they don't have that much of funds. Now in order to recover or fill in that gap, fill that mismatch, they require to borrow the money. Now this to meet certain demands for fund arising out of large outflows, like you might have paid some money or given loan to any of the body, in that case the bank borrows money from the money market. Call money market serves the role of equilibrating the short-term liquidity positions of the bank. Whatever liquidity positions you require is basically being sorted out through money market. Now call money market. It is an integral part of the Indian money market system where day-to-day surplus funds, mostly the banks, are traded. That is, if say bank A, let's SBI, has surplus fund, but the other nationalized bank or the commercial bank, let's say Bank of Baroda, requires money in order to meet any of those funds, they can borrow it from the other bank. The loans are for a short duration of time, say 1 to 14 days, it's not even in month. Money lent for one day is called call money. If it exceeds one day but is less than 15 days, it's called notice money. Money lent for more than 15 days is termed as term money. So there are three types over here as well in call money market. One, call money, that's for one day affair. Notice money is within 1 to 15 days, And if I'm talking of term money, it goes beyond 15 days, but yes, it's less than a year. The borrowing is exclusively limited to banks who are temporarily short of funds. We are not talking of any other institution over here. We are only referring to banks. Now coming to call money market too. Call loans are generally made on a clean basis. That is, no collateral is required. That is, you don't require any parallel security. The main function of the call money market is to redistribute the pool of day-to-day surplus funds of banks among other banks in a temporary deficit of funds. That is, you are helping on a brotherly basis to each other. The call market helps banks economize their cash and yet improve their liquidity. That is, they are using their money in order to give away loans or any other securities which they require for, and also at the same time they are maintaining their liquidity. It is a highly competitive and sensitive market. It acts as a good indicator of the liquidity position. It depends entirely on the bank whether you are able to ensure that the liquidity position of the bank is being maintained or not. Call money market participant, that is, who all are the ones who participate in call money market? Those who can both borrow and lend in the market. Now, you can always not be a borrower. You need to be at the upper hand as well, that is, you are lending money. It can be RBI, banks and primary dealers. Once upon a time, selected financial institutions, IDBI, UTI, mutual funds were also allowed in the call money market only on the lender side. That is, they can also give away money. These were phased out and call money market is now a pure interbank market since August 2005. Now, what's a bill market? Treasury bill market, also called as a T-bill market. These bills are short-term liabilities. They range from 91 days, 182 days or 364 days, again within a year, of the Government of India. Now you can even learn this by or try to remember it. That is 3 days, 3 months, 6 months or a year. It is an IOU. Now please remember, IO is OWE. That is, of the government, a promise to pay the stated amount after expiry of the stated period from the date of issue. They are issued at discount to the face value and at the end of maturity, the face value is paid. For example, the bill could be of say rupees 100. I am just giving you an example. But it is issued to you at rupees 75. Now, at the time of maturity, let's say after 91 days, you will be paid rupees 100. Now, this balance of rupees 25 is your benefit. The rate of discount and the corresponding issue price are determined at each auction. Now these are auctioned in the market. RBI auctions 91 day T-bills on a weekly basis, 182 day T-bills and 364 T-bills on a fortnightly basis. That is, after every 15 days on behalf of the central government. That is, you are lending money to the Government of India. Money market instrument are those which have maturity period of less than 1 year. Now that's the key characteristic of that particular market. The most active part of the money market is the market for overnight call and term money between banks and institution and repo transactions. Call money or repo are very short-term money market products. Money market instrument, they include certificates of deposits, commercial paper, interbank participant certification, interbank term money, treasury bills, bill rediscounting, call or notice or term money, or CBLO. Market repo. Now, what is certificate of deposit? They are short-term borrowings issued by all scheduled banks and are freely transferable by endorsements and delivery. That is, you can very easily transfer this particular certificates to anybody. This was introduced in 1989. Maturity of not less than 7 days and maximum up to a year. They are allowed to issue CDs for a period between 1 year and up to 3 years, financial institutions are allowed to do it, subject to payment of stamp duty under the Indian Stamp Act 1899, issued to individuals, corporations, trust, funds and association. They range from 7 days at least to a year, or even can exceed up to 3 years, and they can be issued by financial institutions as well to individuals, corporation, trust and funds. They are issued at discount rate freely determined by market or investors. Commercial papers. There are again short-term borrowings by the corporates, financial institution, primary dealers from the money market. They can be issued in the physical form or DMAT form. That is, either physically you can transfer them or in a dematerialized form. They were introduced in 1990. When issued in physical form, are negotiable by endorsement and delivery and hence highly flexible. Issued subject to minimum of rupees 5 lakhs and in the multiple of rupees 5 lakhs after that. Now that is a heavy amount. Maturity is 7 days to a year. Unsecured and backed by credit rating of the issuing company. Now this is a very basic thing to remember. Apart from being a short-term borrowing, this is not being backed by a security. Issued at a discount to the face value. Market repos. Repo is repurchase agreement. Instrument enable collateralized short-term borrowings through the selling of debt instrument, that is the borrowing instruments. A security is sold with an agreement to repurchase it at a predetermined date and rate. Now this is priorly fixed, that is at what rate will it be purchased and at what date it is going to be purchased. Reverse repo is a mirror image of repo and reflects the acquisition of a security with a simultaneous commitment to resell. You have purchased it and reverse repo is you are going to resell the same. Average daily turnover of repo transaction other than the Reserve Bank increased from 11,311 crore during April 2001 to rupees 42,252 crore in June 2016. Thank you.